Hello, I'm Dr. Chris Williams, Emeritus Professor of Psychiatry at the University of Glasgow and also Director of Five Areas Limited. Exams can feel a real burden. So much to learn, so little time, the importance of results. But the good news is, even when things seem very stressful, there are approaches that can really help in a way that helps you learn not just the subjects, but also learn important things about yourself as well. Often when you're facing the amount of work in different subjects and across a number of subjects, the amount of work feels huge. And of course, you take it one step at a time. And it's that same principle for how to revise and plan your revision for each of the different subjects. So look at the curriculum, look at the coursework that you've done in lectures and lessons, look at the different notes and the revision books that you have, and try and get a plan to cover everything over the days and weeks as you prepare. Try and cut down the amount of information you have to revise. A way of doing that is go through your course notes and books and try and summarize them as shorter notes. Try and work out how you learn best. Is that alone? Is it with other people? Is it in a particular room, sitting at a particular desk? What are the distractions that put you off? So try and really think this one through. If you're going to learn with others, that can be a real encouragement, but make sure it doesn't get too social and too distracting. Try and use all your senses to help you to learn. So write things down, speak things out loud, use colour, use pens, write things out in, for example, illustrations and join ideas together. You may have come across the idea of mind maps developed by Tony Buzan, for example. That's potentially a way that people can try and summarise huge amounts of information in very graphical ways across a sheet. Try testing yourself as well. You can get books or try tests that are online. It's useful to do this because it helps you discover what you're strong on and also what you're weaker on. Keep focused and turn social media off. Ideally, turn your phone off while you're revising. Even better, let your friends know that for a few weeks while the exams are up and while you're really focusing on them, that you're going to be off social media for a time. Make sure you look after yourself. That means eating regularly, breakfast, lunch and evening. It also means thinking about wind down times before bed. So don't spend every hour of the evening working right until you go to bed. Be aware of other things like caffeine drinks. Make a plan to build in rewards during each week. So if you're working hard, have something to look forward to. Also have something planned in the future, beyond the exam, something to really look forward to, possibly something bigger. Maybe going away or meeting up with friends, something you've really wanted to do. Whatever happens when the exam results come out, whether you've done well or badly, you can learn from it. So if you do well, that's fantastic. Pat yourself on the back. It sounds great, but reflect on what helped you do well. If you found things didn't go so well, maybe there's some subjects that you did worse in, or maybe didn't do well across the range of subjects. Again, it's actually good to know. It's good to discover these things so you can make different plans for the future. You can download a handout which contains lots of useful hints and tips that have been produced by Sam H. It's called Testing Times. But hopefully through all of this, you can learn important things about yourself as well as the various subjects that you're learning at the moment. I do hope that learning is helpful and useful for you and that things go well.